tourism, seafood. These are all industries that contribute to Louisiana's unique economy. But in the backyards of Louisiana, horse breeding is one booming industry that affects the U.S. each year.
The business right now is the biggest that it's ever been since its inception when the Louisiana Thoroughbred Breeders Association started, which was in 1961. In 1961, there were 167 foals that were registered in the state. Today, there are over 3,000 foals in Louisiana that are registered.
While horse breeding is widespread throughout the state, some of the sport's finest breeders are here in St. Tammany Parish.
I grew up in New Orleans, and I got my first good horse when I was 11 years old, and rode, had her at the police stables, ended up training horses, the police horses for the Mardi Gras parades as an exchange for my horse being there. And then I went to college and came home and started working for my father's business at the tack shop in New Orleans at the fairgrounds, and then started training horses from there.
Horses are beautiful and powerful creatures. But how do you breed a champion? Bloodlines are a major factor in this, but bloodlines aren't everything. So, how do you turn a horse into a champion?
I've got a little horse here that the mother was very well bred. The father was average to what you consider a low end, but he ran and was Horse of the Year in 06 here.
Meteor Impact's got it won. Meteor Impact's going on to a 5-length score with Wit Ante up for second, just in front of Light and Not.
Meteor Impact is the oldest horse that we've raised. He's 8 years old, in the middle of his 8-year-old year, and he's probably the best that he's ever been. So we'll see. In December, there'll be Champions Day, which is what we're pointing for. He's won it. He won it in 02, he won it in 06. And if 08 comes back, he might be the oldest horse, oldest Louisiana bred to ever do it 3 times.
Most people just see the end result, a champion. But behind all the medals and glory, life on the farm can be pretty hectic. No matter how organized you are, you can't predict what the day will bring.
I really am vigilant about making sure that personalities go together. Some mares don't get along with the other mares, and then they'll kick their babies. It's the type of business that these animals are living, breathing. They have good days, bad days. They get hurt. Some need time. Some get sour. Some don't like to do it.
Breeding and raising horses are a challenge. Cleaning, feeding, and caring for the horses is a demanding full-time job, but the rewards are great.
It is absolutely a labor of love.
For me, personally, the business gives to me. The horses give to me in ways that it's beyond a monetary value for me. You know, the racetrack's exciting. I love the horses. It's very exciting to see a baby that's born here, own the mare, own the stallion, own the baby, and then the horse gets to the races. And then you see, you know, all the work that goes into getting them there. It's not just race day for me. It's 2 or 3 years of prep work getting them there is the most gratifying part of it for me. I'm living the dream that I had when I was 3 years old, that I was a little girl riding horses with my fat horse and my britches, and now I'm, you know, I trained horses, and now I'm breeding horses, and I'm lucky to be doing what I love to do.
Thank you for tuning in. I know how hard it is to take your eyes off of a handsome stud like me. And the words of my good friend Porky. That's all, folks.